in the cage battle here in London, and with me I have Catherine Costigan, who will be facing Alexandra Rolla during KSW 50th event. Hello, Catherine.
Hello. Thank you for having me.
Okay, thank you as well. So basically, I noticed that you were pretty late over there. Like, you came straight for the morning weigh-ins. What was the situation like? And if everything is okay, tell us briefly.
Oh, everything is absolutely fine. It was just some personal issues on my own family side, which KSW I made aware of the minute I accepted the match. I did inform them as well, but everything is all good there. But I did say that I would not be able to do to today. But I will say I will show up. I'll be 100% professional. I'll be ready to go and ready to weigh. Probably a little bit low in weight, but I do normally fight at 48 kilos atom weight. So for me, this was an interesting concept to fight without any dehydration within my body, any cutting weight, see how strong I'll be on the night and how much it'll benefit me in the later rounds. I'm going to be very interested to see that.
Pytanie dotyczyło dosyć późnego dotarcia Katrin na ceremonię wczesnego ważenia dzisiejszego poranku. Dopiero w tym momencie dołączyła do tego Fight Weeku KSW. Tłumaczy tutaj względami rodzinnymi, o których organizacja wiedziała przed zakontraktowaniem tego pojedynku. Także wszystko poszło zgodnie z planem. Katrin stawiła się na czas, wypełniła limit wagowy. Zazwyczaj walczy w kategorii do 48 kg, więc ten pojedynek inny niż wszystkie dotychczasowe. Bez odwodnienia, bez cięcia wagi wejdzie do walki z Olą Rolą i ma nadzieję, że dzięki tym faktom zachowa więcej siły w późniejszych rundach.
Okay, yesterday I spoke with your opponent, Ola, and she is very aware of your skills and of your record, which is pretty impressive. You're more experienced when it comes to the professional formula, but also Ola has some certain skills to be a fair opponent towards you. So tell me, what do you know up to now about your opponent, and what was your preparations like?
Okay, so we found out about 3 weeks ago that her other opponent had fallen out, and KSW were looking for someone who was ready to go. That was me, because I'm always training one way or the other, because it's my life, it's my passion, I love it. Anytime we take on an opponent, my head coach Dermot McGrath, Pancration, and myself sit down and look at it in-depthly and see, is there everywhere that it's a good fight for us? I'm not interested in taking fights anymore that aren't going to make sense. When KSW called, it was a huge opportunity. I know she's a very big up-and-coming name, and I know that she obviously wants to take Catherine Costigan out and go forward. Any fighter wants to do that. I can't blame her for that. You know, we're both in it to win. We're both there to give the best performance as well for female MMA and represent to the best. That's what I always want. So I don't want easy fights, and I want to entertain the fans from all over the world that are going to watch tomorrow.
Pytanie dotyczyło Oli, roli jako jej przeciwniczki, co o niej wie, jak się zapatruje na tą walkę. Katrin tutaj podkreśliła, że jak KSW do niej zgłosiło się, od razu wzięła propozycję na poważnie. Wyrosła już z brania wszystkich walk, które mogłyby się jej nie opłacać, natomiast no, ten pojedynek bardzo interesujący. Wie o tym, że Ola Rola jest schodzącą, można powiedzieć, jakąś tam gwiazdą żeńskiego MMA w Polsce i cieszy się, że będzie mogła wejść z nią razem do klatki i udowodnić, która z nich jest lepsza. Ona ma też świadomość tego, że Ola będzie chciała zdobyć kolejne zwycięstwo w rekordzie i gdzieś tam na jej doświadczonym nazwisku troszeczkę bardziej zaistnieć, ale postara się do tego nie dopuścić.
Can you tell us, can you share with us the piece of information about the contract itself that you signed with KSW? How many fights do you predict to fight, and or maybe is it only a one-time thing?
Right now, it's like any fight. Every fight, every contract that you take, I think, is a one-fight thing, because if you don't do so good, it doesn't mean the company is going to use you again. Even if you had a five-fight contract, there's no guarantees. It's really just every fight you must take and put 100% in. So I am sure if I give them 100%, and obviously I took it on short notice, and if I put on a show and perform, I'm sure that companies have always worked with me because of my professionalism and because of my attitude towards what I'm doing within the octagon. I take it very serious. They're not going to have someone who's going to mess about here. I'm very serious with what I do. It is a job to me.
No, Katrin traktuje swoje walki, swoje występy jak pracę, jest profesjonalistką. Zapytana o to, na ile walk podpisała kontrakt z KSW, odpowiedziała, że no, tak naprawdę nie ma to znaczenia, bo nawet po jednym nieudanym występie, nawet jeżeli zawodnik podpisuje kontrakt na 5 walk, mogą go zwolnić, mogą nie chcieć skorzystać z jego usług. Tak więc ona zamierza dać z siebie 100% i udowodnić organizacji, że warto będzie ją zaangażować w kolejne walki.
Yeah, you give me the impression that you're very fresh in what you do, how you behave, and your general mood is very like, if I can describe it, like young. I would use the word, but that's not definite. But it's not exactly something that people describe you as a person, as an athlete, because usually, you know, you the age of fighters is you know, like younger. Yeah, okay, so and you tell that it's your job. So, what do you think about your future? How long will you use it as your job, and how do you see it in the future?
Oh, it's hard to know what happens in the future if we could all look at that. But what I have done through my whole career is built a fantastic gym in Limerick, in Ireland, for all kids from 4 up to train in MMA, male and female. And these kids now, some of them have turned into future fighters that may go to the world, amateur championships, represent Ireland. That is my future as a coach. Come Monday morning, I'll be back in teaching, training, inspiring others, inspiring all those kids that follow me. That's one point of it. The other point is I must challenge myself so I can become better as a teacher for them. So if I don't have these hard challenges, I won't understand how to become a better coach for them. And that needs to evolve as well. So there's two parts to why I fight. And one is the evolution of me understanding how to train people better.
Katrin nie jest najmłodszą zawodniczką, tego dotyczyło właśnie pytanie, jak długo może potrwać jeszcze jej kariera, jak długo zamierza ona występować w klatce i co potem, kiedy ta kariera się zakończy. No tutaj Katrin zreklamowała swoją szkołę walki, która mieści się w Irlandii, jest tam sekcja dla kobiet, sekcja dla dzieci, wypuszczają zawodników na amatorskie mistrzostwa świata, także bardzo również w tym się realizuje, jest to jej pasja i jeśli będzie musiała kiedyś zawiesić rękawice na kołku, to na pewno poświęci się temu w 100%.
Catherine, thank you so much for the talk. We see each other at the ceremony of weigh-ins, which is pretty soon, I must say. So there is also a photo shot session ahead of you. Are you excited about that? Do you like the media thing, social media, all the duties that you have to face? Because fighter's life, it's not only about fighting. So what's your approach towards that?
My approach is to use it as much as you can, because then you reach out to the person that's going to buy the ticket on the night and they go, I want to see Katrin Koskin. Oh, I've seen her in a blog recently. I've seen her life. It's not so different to mine. Maybe I can become an MMA fighter. I like to show people me, who I am. There's no problem with it. I'm 100% honest in who I am. So they can inspire themselves to do something different in their life. That's what it's all about, really. So I love connecting with the fans, the social media. You guys help us. So we need to help you back. It's no problem for me.
Pytanie dotyczyło obowiązków medialnych przed galą. Czy Katrin lubi te elementy poza walką, które się pojawiają w całej otoczce? Ona odpowiedziała, że bardzo, bardzo to lubi. Lubi prezentować się fanom, lubi z nimi rozmawiać, inspirować ich. I jeżeli my jako media czy inne osoby, które promują wydarzenie, dokładają się, to ona też chce to samo oddać w drugą stronę i tym samym podziękować. Także wszystko jak najbardziej komfortowo przebiega.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.